In this video, I'm going to answer a question I get a good amount, and it has to do with how you derive a datum. Now, a datum is a theoretical point, line, axis, or plane. What's the difference between a line and an axis? I have absolutely no idea. It's not super clear in Y14.5. Does it matter? Maybe, but I'm not going to get into it here. Now, the version of the question I get, say we're going to have this cylinder serve as a datum A. So we want the axis of that cylinder, and we're going to position this larger cylinder to the axis of that. Now we can position it with position or run out to control the coaxiality in the form. It doesn't matter too much. What matters is we're calling it out to datum A. Now, say we're going to have our size 30 plus or minus 5 millimeters. And we're going to have a straightness of 2 millimeters, right? So we can put our datum feature symbol on that feature control frame. And I think this is where it causes problems. So straightness of the derived median line applies to a feature of size. But the thing we're referencing over here is still an axis, okay? So we're going to make sure our derived median line is within this limit. And then this kind of goes away for inspection. What I mean is, we check this, but to check that position, we're going to simulate this cylinder the same way we would any other cylinder, right? Because it's called out, regardless of material boundary, we need a collapsing cylinder to check this. The straightness has nothing to do with that, okay? So I've heard that before, you know, oh, it's A to the derived median line. No, no, it's still the axis here. Now, straightness of the derived median line applies to a feature of size. What if it's applying to the surface? So here we have a cylindricity of 2 millimeters, and now we've got our datum feature symbol on this, right? Not a feature of size control, we're controlling the surface. The same thing applies. We're gonna verify this cylindricity, and then we're going to inspect it the same. We treat this cylinder as an axis, right? However we grab it with a chuck or a collet or a V-block if we have to stabilize it, we're considering this axis. With something like runout, the axis of the feature is what we're spinning around, not the surface of the feature. And I know that sounds weird, you know, physically you're touching the surface, but it's the axis you're spinning around. Now, let me try to make some sense of that. Say you've got a lathe chuck and you grab something in it, you're spinning about the axis of the chuck, right? So if I put something crooked in a chuck, say, you know, not even a lathe chuck, say a cordless drill, right? If I put, a crooked drill bit in it, it's going to spin about the axis of the chuck of the drill, not the axis of a crooked drill bit, okay? It would be the same if this had more cylinders and we had like a runout here. The runout is somewhat similar to cylindricity in that you're controlling the surface. The runout is also going to control the coaxiality to something else. So I didn't include it here. I don't want to get into all of that. But this is for an axis or a center plane. If it's a center plane, you might have a derived median plane flatness on it. Not super likely. You're not going to see that out in the wild too much, but it's a possibility. But you're going to use the center plane, not the derived median plane. In this case, a derived median line gets checked and you can kind of forget about it. It's not what you're going to use as the datum. Or datum's got to be an axis, a perfectly straight line, where a derived median line isn't necessarily perfectly straight. So that's it. It's a shorter video than usual, but it's something I really wanted to discuss. If you enjoyed it, please like, subscribe, leave a comment down below. Let me know what you think.